لك مور جونز.
Hi everybody, my name is John Varis. I stay in South Africa, Western Cape, in a place called Paarl. And the place I stay in Paarl is called Lantana, number 10 Lupini Street. I'm a Rastafarian, and what I do for a living is I sell fruit and vegetable every day. And sometimes I go out to a gig because I'm a musician. I'm a guitar player and lead vocalist in the band. See, my influence in music come from way back, days way back when I was a youth. That time we don't have electricity. We stay in dusty roads, and yeah, the place was still busy to develop that time, but it was very crucial times that time. The environment that I grown up in was like the youths in the ghettos, the rude boys, we call them rude boys. They love to sing and play acoustic guitar, and yeah, they sing music of Eric Clapton, the Bee Gees, Stevie Wonder. And I, as a youth, I used to stand and watch how they play and how they sing. And that's even how I learned to play music, because I watched it carefully, how they put their fingers on the guitar neck. And when they come, my brother come at home at night and he bring the guitar, I want to do the same thing what they do. Put my fingers the same to find out the chords, how they combine chords and play, how they create rhythm out of it, you see. And yeah, that's how I learned to play. What I learned is they sing about the politicians, how they abuse their power, how they can fool the people. And yeah, they sing about love. They sing about day-to-day happenings in life, day-to-day liberty. But most of all, they want to bring the message across unto the people about Rastafari, about African consciousness, black consciousness, about black liberation struggle and freedom to the black people. Rastafari for me is a very healthy lifestyle. We love to eat fresh food, and yeah, we drink herbs, and when we even cook food, put some herbs in and things, and we love to drink some herbs and even ganja. Some of us smoke ganja, some of us cook it and drink it, and some of us don't even smoke. And I and I lifestyle is we must live clean, because cleanliness is next to godliness. And I and I wear the dreadlocks because I and I, Rastafarians, Nazarites, you know. But it doesn't mean to say if you want to be a Rastafarian, you must have dreads. You don't have to dread to be a Rasta, because Rasta is not about the dreads alone. It's what you know and what you accept about Rasta liberty. Haile Selassie I is the root of King David, the great grandson of King Solomon and the Queen of Sheba. And according to Ethiopian kingdom, the dynasty of the Ethiopian kingdom is Emperor Haile Selassie I, the 225th emperor, which sit on the throne of King David. That's why 1930 Haile Selassie I was crowned as the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the conquering lion out of the tribe of Judah, the root of King David. And that is fulfillment of the biblical prophecy of the book of Revelation, Revelation 5. And that is the message what Rastafarians want to get across to the people, that they must know, that they must understand that God has revealed himself unto the nations of the earth as the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah in Ethiopia, out of Africa, Addis Ababa, and that the lion of Judah is a black man. Look more, Jones. You see, God come out of Africa, Ethiopia, because God come out of the Garden of Eden, because he's the creator of the Garden of Eden. The Garden of Eden for I and I is Africa. And out of Africa come all the people of the earth. And redemption for all the people of the earth out of Africa. And that's what the world should know. Rastafarians want to get that message across unto the world. That is what attracted Ayman to become a Rastafarian and become very faithful in what I know about Rastafari. It's not that I believe because the next man can come and make me believe the way he believes. Rasta say, this is the time that we must not believe, we must know. We rather must know and not believe, because your beliefs can be taken away. I don't want to believe. I want to know more and more and more, so that I can teach my people more and more and more about Rastafari liberty. Give thanks to the Lord.